Hi everybody, welcome to our new video. Today we're going to show you how to change your Huawei router's IP address. You get me? So in case you have a router and maybe you connect to the internet, there's some conflicting IP addresses, you don't understand what is going on, you have to sometimes, and you think maybe there is another device which has the same IP address as your router, and you don't know how to access those device or to change that device. We're gonna show you today how to change your Huawei router IP. It's not only Huawei; it can be another also router, maybe Netgear, maybe D-Link, maybe Cisco, any other kind of a router. Because sometimes you find like that IP is already used, so we need to get a unique IP so that we don't have any conflicts on the network. So that's the reason why we're going to create this video. We're creating this video for you. So what you do, this is a Huawei. I'm using a Huawei, and it's a Wi-Fi router, a wireless router. It's a B315. So now what we're gonna do, we're gonna have our router here. We need two things. First, power, put it on, put a network cable in it, also put power cable in that, then you give it a chance to, okay, then you power it on here, okay, then you connect your cable to your laptop or your computer, whatever. Okay, after doing that, then it's gonna be fine. Okay, so once you do that, we're gonna wait for the cable to show here. The cable should show here. This is fine, that's fine. So now we're gonna also need a cable here to show up. I think I'm over occupied here by some things here. Okay, I'm gonna get what they call, I should get a mouse myself. Get myself a mouse. Something I need to get. Okay, right now you go to your browser, and what you do, you log in by 192. That modem, you look at the modem, then you get the IP. So if you don't know what you do, some modems, the IPs are put at the back here, you get me? But this one, this time, you're gonna get it here. You can see, you can turn it to see super fine. Okay, the gateway, you can see, is 192, that's what they call the IP. 192.168.8.1, okay, get that. We're gonna do exactly that. 192, you can see. Okay, we're gonna hit the button. Okay, once you're there, it should log in. You see, it's here. Then there's no SIM card, it's fine. You say home. Once you go home, it's gonna ask you for your username and password. Okay, you see, it asks the username and password. If you don't have it, you still have to go to your modem. Most of modems, their IPs are written. You can find something like this. Okay, what is that? You can see there the IP address. Everything's there, but now we're looking for the password, which they did not write here. Yeah, it's there. You can see user password, user admin password, admin. You can see those two. Okay, use that. Okay, they say user is admin. Then password, admin. You hit enter. Okay, it takes you here. Okay, once you're here, I'm gonna give you something. You can say next. Do you want to modify that? If you want to change your
Also your Wi-Fi name, you can change it and say YMB, whatever you want to. If you want to modify also your internet, you can call it 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay, you can change that also. You can say 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Say next. Okay, so now to proceed, you have to give the previous password and a new password, because it won't give you access to everything before you change the password, because they expect this is new and everybody knows that to log into a router is admin. So that simply means they might go into your router without knowing. So they want to protect you here. They ask you to put in the current password and the new password you want. I usually use admin. Okay, the first one, then the second one, the new one. Okay, I'll say admin. Okay, that's fine. Then we finish. After finishing, wow, it didn't work. The new password did not work. There's something wrong. I didn't do it well. Okay, I'm gonna finish. Once it's done, then it's gonna say success, okay, which is okay. Then I can save that. Then to log in, then go to settings, it might ask you the password again, but it didn't do that. So what you do, you go to learn, okay, then you say HDPC, okay. When you click there, then it's going to give you this number. You can see this number, this is the IP number we have here. So you can change it to whatever you want. I want to make this one to be maybe, I would give it. Maybe I would say 600. That's what I gave it. And apply. I'm gonna do this, but I'm gonna disable this, but that's not, you don't have to do that. Okay, let me leave it. I'm gonna apply that. That's the way you change your password, your IP, you apply. You say please re-enter empty what? Oh, this is an invalid. It says it's invalid. Okay, if I say 100, 0, 0, I make it 100. What will it say? To 200. Okay. It says it should be in the range of 100 to 200. Okay. The start IP is empty. Oh, what's going on here? Let me go here. The start IP is empty. Okay, let me go to 87. Then apply. Okay. Few moments. Put 87 this side this time. It can even tell you that you put the range from 100 to 200. That's the range it's giving you. So now what it did, I'm sure it did, it's trying to save the settings we've made here. Let's give it a chance. Okay, then it did not give it stopped, it saved that. So now to log into this, we no more going to use 10.192.168.8.1. No, it's now .87. You can see even here That's what we're gonna do. So now your IP has changed for the router. So you log in here. You see it's now 192.168.8.87. Then you go in there. You now say connect settings or settings. Click on settings. Gonna ask you for username and password. I'm gonna say admin. Admin, the username I use, the admin is the same, but we will never change the username. Then the password should be the one you change, the new password. So after logging in, it's gonna give you access to everything. So we've logged in. So now you can go to settings. Then you click on, you can see those are settings. You click on line where we were. One wireless. Okay, brings this, forget this. When you go to one Mac, whatever, let me see, filter, all of those settings, you leave them. When you go to advanced settings, okay, you can see all the advanced settings, whatever. One basic settings, you can see all that, everything is still the same. You get me? One. Okay, so now you can go to HTPC. That's where we set our password. Okay, our, you can see that now our IP is what? Is 87. 192.168.8.87. So now this is the IP you're gonna be using, don't forget it. Whenever you want to log into the modem, but if you get problems on that, disconnect your laptop. Maybe you forget after 4 or 5 months or 3 months, you never know. Then you go, you reset the modem. I showed you how to reset the modem in the beginning of the what of the video. Now we can see we have our LAN working. You get me? So the IP is different. Let's see if we can go to internet. No, we can't go to internet because we took out the SIM card in there. But it's gonna go to internet if the SIM card is in and everything. Guys, thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe. This is the way you change your IP address for your modem. It can be any type of modem. You do the same trick, but sometimes the menu changes and the way they might call some links, but it's the same thing. Thanks for watching, guys. See you in the next video. Even if you want to change your 5G modem, you use the same trick. Okay, please, guys, don't forget to subscribe.